I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna let the reason out that his love goes on forever. I'm gonna take it all the way.
Hi, I'm Pastor Bill, and this is the Maple Minute this Tuesday, September the 12th, 2023. We're talking about biblical characters, and today we're going to talk about a tough act to follow, the life of Elisha. In 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 15, the Bible says, the company of the prophets from Jericho who were watching all that happens, said, the spirit of Elijah is resting on Elisha. Now, I'm taking this one verse, but I'm not taking it out of context, but what they're referring to is the fact that Elisha, this second prophet, actually he was the servant to Elijah, he had requested, as Elijah is translated or taken up to heaven, he had asked for a double portion of the spirit of Elijah on him to be able to do the ministry, carry on without him. And that is a tough act to follow. If you know anything about Elijah, and we talked about him in a couple episodes ago, Elijah was an outstanding, tough prophet of God. He was one of the hallmark prophets of the Old Testament because he stood in some of the most evil days against a king and queen that were really ridiculously evil. Elisha, he's a young man the first time we see him. He's plowing his father's fields when he first encounters this prophet Elijah. And Elisha immediately drops everything to follow him. And for years he would serve as the apprentice or servant to Elijah while Elijah performed his duties as the prophet of God under some of the most extreme circumstances that we've already talked about. Elisha absorbed the example set by Elijah, and this influence helped shape Elisha's outlook. Now, it's hard to keep saying these two names, but when the time came for Elijah to depart and God decided to carry him up to heaven in a whirlwind, Elisha was ready to assume his role now as the new prophet of God. He had been mentored, he had been discipled, he had been apprenticed, whatever you want to use. And what's amazing is Elijah, though he faced some pretty tough circumstances, Elisha faces circumstances that Elijah never did. So while he greatly was influenced by Elijah, Elisha had to walk a unique path God had laid out for him. Elisha was quickly reminded that where God's work is going to go on, there's going to be opposition. And during his 65 years of service, Elisha became a revered and beloved fixture among God's people. Like his mentor, Elijah, he was renowned for his fearsomeness and his faithfulness in serving God. And when he died, the entire nation of Israel mourned. Elisha had been schooled by one of the best, but ultimately his ministry and influence and legacy were unlike anyone else's. See, in our lives, what we get from Elisha is God has equipped each one of us with a unique set of skills and abilities and capabilities. He has a unique path that's chosen for each one of us. The circumstances you face, the opportunities you have to make a difference in other people's lives, and the specific calling that you've been given by your Heavenly Father, it's so unlike anything else. See, your journey in life, your journey on that path with God is just that. It's your journey. You don't get to take and make it somebody else's journey, or you can't copy somebody else's journey. And one of the best ways to prepare for that journey is to observe the lives of other trusted, mature believers. That's the good thing. That's what we see from what Elisha did as he looked on to the life of Elijah. See, a mentor is a gift from God. There are things you can learn from their successes and failures that can have a tremendous impact on your Christian life, your Christian walk, your Christian experience. My dad always told me that you can learn something from everyone, whether it's good or bad, you can always learn something. And he wasn't wrong. And I think most of us know that. So let's ask a couple questions as we wrap up today's lesson on Elisha. First of all, name the most influential Christians in your life up to this point, and what specific lessons have you learned from each one of them? It'd be great if you took some paper out and just wrote down some names and then wrote what you've learned. It'll help you as you think through things. Number two, has their influence, these people that have influenced you, shaped your Christian walk from the way you interact with others to the way you study God's word? How have they done that? So be specific on that. And then last of all, if someone were to look at you as a mentor, What lessons could they gain from your relationship? And that's a huge question. What is your life teaching other people? I hope it's teaching people to be a better Christ follower, to draw closer to God and Jesus. So take some time, implement these into your life, maybe discuss them with some people that you want to mentor or you're in an accountability group with. That would be a great time to just absorb that. So until next time, thanks for joining me at the Maple Minute.
I'm gonna praise Jesus' name, 'cause His love goes on forever. His love reaches to the highest mountain. His love stretches to the lowest valley. His love